That's what I understand, yeah. Have you talked to Dan yet? I understand you're going to. Well, I don't know what he told you.
I'll tell you after you tell me.
Yeah, no, I can tell you, I feel, I've never felt safe.
Do you have any problems left related to the shooting? Any physical problems?
No. No, as a matter of fact, I'm amazed at how hard I have to look now to see the extensive scars.
You don't want to do a Lyndon Johnson and show them to us, do you?
No, you can catch me, come summer, in a swimming suit.
How often?
See how old-fashioned I am, I still call trunks a swimming suit.
How often do you see Dr. Lindy?
Well, I have to see him pretty frequently, every couple of weeks or so, to stop in to get my sneeze shots. I still have my little hay fever allergy, and I've discovered that Sacramento and Washington have something in common. They must be the allergy capitals of the world.
You get, what is that, a couple of weeks? Someone said that you also have, like, allergies to feathers and the stuffing in some of the chairs. Is that?
Yes, as a matter of fact, here, I've been wondering if some of my problem isn't indoors as much as out, because I can go up to David or a few days at the ranch or anything, and wouldn't even hear my voice now, and it's just fine. I come back here, and within 24 hours, I kind of had that little allergic stuffiness.
I want to clear something up. The Times reported on your birthday that you haven't had a physical in 2 years. Is that the case? The last one was April when you went out to the hospital by helicopter?
I guess so, yeah. Although there have been interim things like, and because of trips and so forth, they a blood test on me, something of that kind. But
why is that? It's the first time, according to the records, it's the first time in like 20 years you haven't had an annual physical.
Well, Dan doesn't happen to be a believer in those. After that length of time, he doesn't think they're that essential. Now this year we will. He's told me that we'll do some testing when we clear the schedule here a little bit. But
well, when you were considering whether to run again, weren't you curious as to that you were in top shape, that your health was in good shape to go another 5 years?
Yeah, but now we've dwelt on those allergies for so long, let's get around to the good part of it. There's just no question. I honestly believe I work out daily in that gym upstairs at the end of the day. I'm still at every opportunity when the weather permits, riding, as I always say.
The weather never seems.
Yeah, this has been the longest stretch, I think, of not being able to. I honestly am in excellent shape. And as I say, I think in
you didn't
better
have
shape
any curiosity more about going through a full physical just to make absolute sure?
No, because I felt so good. Part of my workouts, I get on a treadmill and climb uphill on that treadmill and have it set to a climb, that's part of the workout. I do that every day. Mm-hmm. And I know how I feel.
When you were campaigning in 1980, when some of your advisors thought that age might be an issue, it didn't turn out to be, you pledged to take regular physical and mental tests and release it to the public while you were in office. Now, whatever happened to those? I haven't seen one.
Well, no, I said if ever.
By the way, Larry says press conferences fill that
yes,
subject. But
yes. No, if you'll know what I actually said at that time, because everyone was asking, so, you know, my mental faculties were not going to be able to survive. And I said if I ever had any indication that I was drifting into something of that kind, I certainly would.
It was conditioned on if you found yourself having memory problems or something,
yeah.
It wasn't an actual.
And no, and then Nothing like that has happened.
Do you, when you take this, the physical you're going to take this year, will you release that publicly?
Will I what?
Make that public?
Oh, I'm sure Dan is always, no, I was just gesturing in that direction. Occasionally, if I look out the windows to see if the squirrels are still eating the acorns, I brought down a great big bag of acorns from Camp David and I put them out there in the stone.
I remember reading about that. Come on.
Dan does that and answers any queries. And there's never been any reason not to answer them.
Well, when I spoke to him, he said that most of that information really isn't a public's business. It's between you and me as your doctor. And as you know, we haven't seen a report like that. And I'm wondering, this being an election year and perhaps people perhaps wanting to be reassured, if you would make that public.
Well, I'll venture to say that when the campaign gets underway, it will be the same as it's been all the way back to those years when I was traveling the mashed potato circuit for the GE Theater. And that is that I'll be still going when the rest are in a state of collapse. I remember back in those years on that theater that I'd go into a town where there was a plant and then all the schedule that they'd have for me. And usually my leaving would be as they said goodbye, they'd say, "We're glad you're getting out of town."
No, I'm not implying anything other than the fact that we haven't seen an actual report like that, and some of the Democratic candidates are starting to release reports from their physicians. Do you think your age will become an issue? It didn't in '80.
I can't believe that it will. If it does, I'll challenge him to an arm wrestle.
One eminent psychologist recommended recently to the American Psychiatric Institute that a government, I know you're not going to like this, that a government panel be set up to examine all candidates for the president and report to the public on their health. Would you accept that?
Well, certainly I would accept it if that was what they wanted it, and everyone felt that's what should be done. But I just wonder if we haven't gone so far anymore in the restrictions that are being placed on people in government, in the suspicions that motivate so many things that are being done, not only to elected officials, but to appointees in government, that pretty soon we're going to find that the best people won't seek government as a place of service to their country. I think that's, as I've said, and we run any checks or anything, I'll make sure that Dan knows it's all right with me to answer the questions. But to get back to the health factor, you know, at a time when an awful lot of people I know are worried because their belt size is changing, my worry is that I'm growing out of my coats because I've added an inch and a quarter around my chest.
Are you still doing that?
Sure, every day. Well, 6 days a week. You don't do it. You take one day off. Two different sets of exercise, one 3 days and the other 3 days.
Do you take any medicines?
I take vitamins. Nancy's father, who's a surgeon, as you know, got us in that habit a long time ago, and I don't know what effect it's had, but it must have done something right. And that was, he said that he was not a great believer in a lot of vitamins or anything, but he said, and he prescribed a certain multiple vitamin, he said, we're all of us so careless about our food, and you know, lunch chums, and you grab a sandwich or something, cup of coffee and a roll, that sort of thing. And he said that he'd always believed that this one multivitamin every day would make up for any deficiencies in your diet. And we both got in the habit of doing it. And I suppose you have to call that a medicine. Why, that's a medicine.
Let me turn to one pretty serious subject. Have you considered or discussed what would happen here if you became impaired in your second term somehow?
If I become?
Impaired somehow, you know, constitutionally. If you were impaired, there's a procedure. Have you discussed that?
No. I assume.
Thought never occurred to you that?
No.
Well, I'll try. How about, everything I've read or know about you indicates that you are very optimistic. Do you ever go through periods where you're bothered by stress or of the job or depression about something that's happening?
No, I think I do some reasonable worry about whether a decision that I have to make. The hardest decisions are the ones when there's so much right on both sides. They're not clean cut this way or that way. But no, I think maybe this comes from the previous experience of having been a governor of the largest state in the Union, not in acreage, in population. I remember when I first started that job, yes, I discovered what stress was. And
did it keep you awake, or did you pace? I mean, how did it affect you?
Well, it was just a tension that, mm-hmm. that I had. We had inherited a situation somewhat similar to what we inherited here in California. And it seemed as if every day that I sat down at my desk, there was someone in front of the desk saying, we've got a problem. And I found myself almost with a physical desire to look over my shoulder to see if there wasn't someone I could turn to and tell that to. And I just...
It never caused any real physical problem. It was just something you coped with and got used to.
And I just said to myself one day, look, all I can do is make a decision based on what, to the best of my ability, is my belief in what is right for the people. I had already told the cabinet, others as I have here, that I don't want anyone suggesting things on a basis of the political context, that the decisions will be made on what's right or wrong for our people. And I haven't had that since.
Well, what about anger? You have to, in the past, this morning I got up and saw the Mises stuff all over TV. It was all over TV last night. That sort of thing has to affect you in terms of anger. You must have to cope with that. How do you cope with that?
Oh, sometimes I get mad. My fellas tell me, I wasn't even conscious of it. They tell me that once in a while, they watch when I throw my glasses. they know I'm angry. But yes, I think that's something that is very frustrating is, look, I'm the guy they're after with their demagoguery. Well, all right, then come after me. But quit picking on people who haven't done anything wrong and who actually have made a sacrifice in order to serve in government and try to destroy human beings the way they are. Now, why didn't someone in that splash last night about those cufflinks, why didn't somebody bother to find out that there are at least 9 people, including people at the State Department, who received those gifts from the Korean government when we were there, but all were assured that the terms under which such gifts could be given and accepted had been met by the Korean government. In other words, there is a financial limit below which it is proper. All of them had been told that these gifts came underneath that limit. Now somebody,
Larry was one of the
somebody went out and got a local estimate. Well, do you go by what an estimate is at our kind of inflated prices, or do you go by what they cost the government? over there.
But what do you do when you see that and you say to yourself, this is really unfair?
Yes. I say that, and maybe I say some unprintable language for a minute or two. But I also learned that you can eat yourself up with anger, and I'd rather eat them up.
Mr. President, you're running late here. You've got the Black College
president. We're having so much fun.
Well, I'll tell them one quick anecdote. I was researching this story, and I talked to the doctor. When you had said you'd take these mental tests and put out the results, I was speaking to a doctor who's a specialist in that area and asked him if there's a simple test that you could give a president to assess that. And he said, sure, it's just 3 or 4 questions long, but it won't work in this case. And I said, why not? And he said, the first question is, who's the president of the United States? So I took care of that idea.
All right. Well,
thank you very much.
On your way out, let me just show you something.
You want to arm wrestle?
No, it can't be brought in today.
Yes,
right. There. Now, does that look like I need to take a physical?
Oh, that's good.
And these are all very recent. These are from the last time out there.
Is this the latest issue of National?
Yeah. Yes, so.
So, thanks.
My only illness is, and after looking at this, homesickness.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Well, thank you.